Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
So hello friends, so in today's video we are going to see what is the digital to analog converters. So let's start with the video. Now we have seen what is the need of the ADC and the DAC. So today we are going to see what is the digital to analog converter. First of all, let's clear the very first important concept is that the process of converting a digital data into the analog signal is known as the digital to analog conversion. Okay, it is very important. The process of converting the digital data, that is the digital data means it is in the form of 0 and 1. So this is the analog signal. The process which converts the digital signal into the analog signal is known as the digital to analog conversion. But the device which is used to convert the digital data into the analog form is known as the digital to analog converter. So we are going to see what are the types of digital to analog converters. The digital to analog converter circuits are receiving the input in the form of digital only. That means in the form of 0 or 1. These are the only two states. 0 indicates the low output and the 1 indicates the high output. So digital to analog converters are also known as a parallel converter, which receives the input in the form of digital, that is either 0 or 1. So DAC converters might be also having the 4-bit converters or the 8-bit converters depending on the number of the input lines. So let's see what are the type of the DAC converter. There are always two methods to convert a digital to analog signal. First method is weighted resistor D2A converter. Now why it is called as a weighted resistor? Because we have the ladder of the resistor and to each resistor we have given some weight. That is, we have given some variable value. So that value is known as some weight. So that's why it is called as a weighted resistor method. The next method is R2R ladder D2A converter. Now R2R ladder. Ladder means it is the ladder network of R2R. The value of the resistance will only be R and the 2R. So that's why it is known as the R2R ladder network. Now in the both method, each bit can be either connected to 0 or connected to 1. And the output of the DAC converter will be always in the form of the analog value. Because it is a DAC converter, the output will be always the analog value, and that analog value will be directly proportional to the input binary weightage. For example, the input binary weightage is 2 raised to 4, then the analog value will be proportional to binary weightage of 2 raised to 4. So in detail we are going to see what is the weighted resistor DAC method and what is the R2R ladder D2A converter. So in the next video we are going to see weighted resistor method and R2R ladder video. Now we are going to see the block diagram of D2A converter. Consider a 3-bit D2A converter as shown in this figure. Now in this value, this is a 3-bit converter. Okay, so why it is a 3-bit converter? Because it has a 3 inputs and only 1 output. So each 3-bit input, it is 2 raised to 0, 2 raised to 1 and 2 raised to 3 and 2 raised to 2. And this output will be proportional to the input values of these signals. So thank you friends for watching today's video. In the next videos, we are going to see the type of the DAC converter in detail. So stay tuned to Ikeda channel and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you.